Dear Carbs, I miss you so much. It's only been a week, but I just can't get you out of my mind. Fruits and vegetables are boring. Who wants to eat a parsnip? Nobody. Mashed potatoes, biscuits, lasagna. Spelling? Oh man, I've got to stop thinking about you. I'll go crazy. I promise I'll be back after my high school reunion. Yours, Bob. P.S. I love you. Dear Fruits, it's killing me that I have to eat 5 servings of you every day. Pears are so gross. Stupid guys who made that food pyramid. I'll bet they think they're so smart. I'd like to shove a pear up their butts. Now I know why there's Starburst and Jujubes. Spelling? It's because you're not good enough the way you are. I wish Frankenberry cereal was considered a fruit. Then at least I'd have a puzzle or a maze to complete while I ate you. Whatever. Bob. Dear Carbs, I think we might have been caught. My wife noticed the Domino's box I hid under the urn. We've got to be more careful next time. I told her it was the kids. Close one. B.O.B. Dear Vegetables, now I know why brain-dead people are named after you and not rocks. At least rocks don't taste like despair. You know why broccoli is shaped like a cartoon fart? Because it smells like something that came out of Andy Capp's ass. Yeah, take a look at yourself, you poor excuse for nourishment. Look at an onion. It makes you cry. Then you have to put something else in your mouth after you eat it so your wife won't run away screaming. Stupid! Wheatgrass? Feet grass. Fuck you! Bob. Dear Carbs, oh Christ, I want to put my tongue on you so much. Remember the 2 Cunningham muffins I had yesterday and the French bread this morning? Just wait till I have linguine tonight. My wife's doing yoga till 7. I'm gonna put my whole face in a pie. God, at this point, I put my whole dick in a pie, just like that kid in that movie. And I already know what pussy feels like. Absolutely out of my fucking mind for you, Bob. Dear my wife's pussy, I am so sorry I got pie in you. I'm sure the infection will clear up in a couple of days. How I got pie on me is... because, see, it's a funny story. I was getting out of the shower, and I slid into the kitchen, and I fell on a pie. And then a Yeti stepped on my back, and I fucked the pie. I was very confused about the Yeti, so I didn't think to wash the pie off. And then you came home from yoga, and I thought the best way to protect you would be to have sex with you. The Yeti seemed angry. I've told you about that sliding door lock. I'm not saying it's your fault, but missing you, Bob's penis.
Dear Bob's penis, I haven't heard from you, is that it?